East side of the house is a landmark. You know what the landmark is? 59th and 2nd. So I'm looking out the window. I'm feeling like Gordon Lightfoot. You know Gordon Lightfoot?
So I guess I'll just look at the view from the 35th floor.
Well, growing up, the view from the 35th floor, I said, well, that stinks. Gotta write about something else, and you start to unravel, and hey, boom, material! Music came fairly easily, but the lyrics, ooh, that was tough.
I know women who are in the workforce now that are doing what used to be considered man's work or men's jobs. They're in corporate positions, they're in competitive jobs, and I noticed happening, this is a few years ago, that when a woman became very successful and started taking her own initiative and being aggressive, that she was referred to in negative terms, like, oh, she's a cutthroat and she's really a bitch. Whereas if a guy had been making the same moves in a corporate situation, he'd be, wow, he's got a lot of moxie, you know? And the point of the song was a woman can be competitive in business and be very smart, and it's no threat to my masculinity. I mean, I don't feel threatened by it. And what I was saying in the song was maybe she's aggressive and all those things which are supposed to be masculine in a business situation, but that doesn't take anything away from her being a woman.
Billy Joel, completely retold.
The song Vienna was Billy's reaction to meeting up with his father after not having seen him for 15 years. Billy's dad had left the family on Long Island and gone back to his home country of Austria.
Vienna was, I meant it as a metaphor for the rest of your life. We're pressurized to be, to live all, you know, a lot of life while we're the young people, while we're the Pepsi generation, you know. You got till like you're 40 and then everything's over the hill and life stinks. Bullshit. There is most of your life is when you're older. there's a very short amount of time when you're considered young. And you don't have to live live your whole life within that, maybe that 20-year span.
My father lives in Vienna now. My father moved back to Europe. Him and my mother split up. My father, I had to track him down. I didn't see him from the time I was 8 till I was about 23, 24 years old. So I go to visit my father in Vienna, and I'm walking around in this town, and I see this old lady. She must have been about 90 years old, and she's sweeping the street. I say to my father, "What's this nice old lady doing sweeping the street?" He says, "She's got a job. She feels useful. She's happy. She's making the street clean. She's not put out to pasture. You know, we treat old people in this country pretty badly. We put them in rest homes, and we kind of kick them under the rug, and we make believe they don't exist. And, you know, let them worry about their health care benefits, and, you know, screw them. We don't want to pay attention to them. They've had their day." Well, they don't feel like that. And a lot of these older places in the world, where the culture is older than ours, they value their older people, and the older people feel they can still be a part of the community. And I thought, this is a terrific idea that old people are useful, and that means I don't have to worry so much about getting old, because I can still have a use in this world in my old age. There's also a lot of inside stuff musically on that. So the beginning of it and the end. You know, a composer named Kurt Weill, who wrote the Three Penny Opera. It's very Kurt Weill, I thought. I was trying to get that kind of sick, you know, middle European, kinky, decadent thing, you know. Money, 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 you know.
Yeah. Come, mein Liebchen, you know, kind of. You know.
But they're, you know, at least they're out front about it. You know, you go to England, the English are like, the English are all very proper. You know, they have their little umbrellas, and they have their little, you know, civil row suits. And then they'd be like to go home and spank each other. But because it's so naughty, you know. The middle Europeans are out front.
Yeah, I am a kinky fellow, you know.
But Kurt Weill wrote the Three Penny Opera. Some of you may know the famous song that Bobby Darin did. Oh, the shark bites with its teeth in there, and he shows them. He was trying to do Sinatra, I think. Pearly white. But it was written by this Austrian guy, Kurt Weill.
Oh, the shark bites with its teeth, dear.
A little decadent, that middle European, you know, that.
Hello. Would you like some cheese? Come into the parlor. You will be very comfortable here.
Billy decided to close his album out with a song he had written back in 1970.